Hey guys, so I made a video recently about Hackintoshing in 2021 and whether it's still a viable option or not. Well, today it's a very exciting video because I will be doing a direct comparison between my Hackintosh and the M1 Mac Mini, as well as the M1 MacBook Air. So if you were not sure about building a Hackintosh or getting an M1 Mac, then this video is definitely for you. So we will focus mostly on pure performance. I guess that's what you really want to see, right? So here's a list of the apps and the benchmarks we will go through. This list was inspired by enthusiasts on the Hackintosh subreddit and on the Hackintosh Facebook group. So guys, thank you so much for the suggestions. The Hackintosh you see rocks a Core i9-9900K, a Red Devil 5700XT, 2TB of NVMe Samsung Evo Plus, and 32GB of RAM at 3200MHz. As for the M1, the Mac Mini comes with 16GB of RAM, the MacBook Air only 8GB. And both of them have 256GB of SSD storage. So I think it's a wide range comparison that can cover most user needs, and it took me almost a week to finish. But enough talking, let's get to it. Thank you. Well, there you have it, a full comparison between the Hackintosh and the M1. I have to be honest with you guys, the M1 really blew my mind in terms of how a small chip without any active cooling, especially the MacBook Air in this case, can produce these amazing results. I mean, look at my Hackintosh and how big it is, with all this water cooling and fans. Apple, great job. So after all of this testing, it's pretty clear to me that when it comes to pure CPU performance, the M1 is way ahead. But when it comes to GPU performance, the Hackintosh destroys it. So since the M1 Max cannot support eGPUs, I think that people who do 3D design and motion graphics, as well as gaming on the side, should build a powerful Hackintosh. For video editing, it's actually pretty close. But for most other cases, the M1 is definitely a good buy. And if you can wait a few months, I recommend getting the next version of the M series, whatever Apple ends up calling it. So guys, let me know in the comments below, which one do you think won this comparison? The full Hackintosh guide is coming next week, so please like and subscribe so you not miss that video. Thanks, and see you in the next one.